Danko just released Kortex, his new second brain app especially designed for creators. And Kortex's value proposition is simple. Centralize your notes, your writing, and your content so you can streamline your writing workflow. Basically, Kortex is what would happen if Obsidian and Notion had a baby. And over the past 3 years, I have been a dedicated user of both tools. I'm managing my entire life using Notions with systems for data tracking, journaling, tasks and projects, goals, content creation, and more. I've built a second brain inside Obsidian of 400 permanent notes using the Zettelkasten method. And I've invested 3.5k in courses, templates, and systems to use both of these tools. So when Kortex opened for beta testing, I knew I had to try it. And I instantly fell in love with the concept of having your notes and the content you're writing in the same place. It just makes a lot of sense to me. So after 2 months as an early beta user, I've been able to refine and optimize my existing systems inside Kortex, and that's what I'm about to show you in this video. I will share with you the exact system I use for both learning with the Zettelkasten method and writing high quality content inside Kortex. And stay until the end of this video because I will show you how you can access Noah's Hark Bank, which is a bank of templates and tools to use Kortex and build your own second brain. You will also get access to the mind map of this video with the summary of all the content we're going to discuss together. And you will also get access to free SOPs to implement everything I'm about to show you in this video step by step. Before we begin, let me introduce myself. My name is Noah and I've been in the online entrepreneurship space since I'm 16. I generated 200k on the French market with my SMMA agency, info products and coaching services. I've helped clients generate more than 500k through my services and strategies, but I stopped both of these businesses because they were no longer fulfilling me and they were no longer aligned with my long-term vision. And now I run Noah's Hark. And my goal is to help people obsessed with self-realization to build a business that will be their vessel toward accomplishment and freedom. I will share with you systems that combine psychology, mental model, and systems thinking to help you win the game of life. So now, let's begin. First, we're going to see why systems matter more than tools. Kortex is amazing, but without a system, it won't deliver good results. The biggest mistake people make when switching from tools like Obsidian or Notion is focusing on templates rather than building an integrated system. That's why today I will share with you three proven systems that will transform your learning and writing workflow inside Kortex. First, we're going to see the content acquisition system, how you can feed your Kortex library with high quality content. Then we're going to see the Zettelkasten method, how to convert your highlights into valuable permanent notes that will be the building blocks of your future writing. And finally, the content creation system, how to use your notes with templates to produce impactful content. So first, the content acquisition system, feeding your Kortex library with high quality content. You have to understand that the foundation of great output is high quality input. So you need to prioritize what you consume and you can use the content hierarchy mental model. Basically, the idea is that books are better than studies, that are better than articles, that are better than newsletters, that are better than YouTube videos, that are better than tweets, and that are better than short forms videos. So you get the idea. Of course, it's not always true, but it's a great mental model to keep in mind when you need to prioritize which kind of content you're going to consume with the following system I'm about to show you. The second mental model is following the Lindy effect. Basically, the idea is that the older the content, the more universal its value. Focus on timeless sources like classic books and essays. Now, both of these mental models are just tools that you can use to guide you through the decision making of choosing what you're going to consume. But keep in mind that at the end of the day, you can just follow your curiosity, what you like, what are your current center of interest of the moment, and just follow them and see where it brings you. Now, we're going to see the tools to build your Kortex library. First, we have Readwise. Readwise will sync all of your highlights across devices and different content types and all of the following tools I'm about to show you. It is the keystone of this system and is absolutely crucial. Then we have Amazon Kindle. It is the best tool for reading and highlighting books. My Kindle has been the best investment I've made for my learning and I absolutely don't regret it. So I highly recommend you to just buy a Kindle if you haven't already. It's very useful, it's very flexible. You can read it anywhere. The screen is very good for the eye. You can read on the beach. You can read everywhere you want. And of course, you can directly highlight the books you're reading and those highlights will sync automatically with Readwise. Then we have Snipe, which is the best podcast app for learning. The cool thing with Snipe is that you can listen to a podcast and with a comment from the app or just using your headphones, you can instruct it to save a snippet of the podcast to just listen, and it will save the transcript and also create an AI summary of what has been said, which allow you basically to have highlights from podcast and finally have a way to retrieve the information and the ideas that you found interesting in podcast, which is for me absolutely amazing. Honestly, before discovering Sniped, I was not consuming podcasts at all because I just felt it was a waste of time, because I know that as soon as I heard something, even though it may mark me on the moment, I know I will forget it very quickly. So for me, I was just like, okay, why would I waste my time listening to podcasts? But now that I have Sniped, I can listen to podcasts and I know that if there is some key elements that I want to save, I just can, and I will be able to retrieve it in my Readwise, which will be in my Kortex library. And then we have Reader by Readwise, which is a Reddit later hub. Basically, the idea with Reader is that you will be able to save contents to consume for later with their Chrome extension. And basically from then, you can highlight articles, PDFs, newsletter, YouTube videos, and also add RSS feeds to have the content automatically imported inside Reader. So the idea is to create your own feed of high quality content that is created by you and not by an algorithm. And of course, all of the highlights are stored and synced in one place and synced with Readwise, which will be synced with Kortex. So that's the way you build a very large and interesting library of highlights inside Kortex that will serve as the building blocks of your future notes, and your future notes will be the building blocks of your writing. So now that you know the tools to make this system work, we're going to see the routine to apply to actually learn new things every day, create new valuable highlights that you will then be able to use, or the next step of the system. So the content acquisition routine. First, you can save articles, newsletter, and RSS feeds to Reader. So that way you create your own feed of curated content. Then you can read books on Kindle and highlight the key insight and paragraph for reference. I advise to use the Tai Lopez routine, which is basically reading 15 minutes in the morning, 15 minutes after lunch, and 15 minutes before bed. It's a very easy way to read 45 minutes to an hour per day. Then you can listen to podcasts during commutes or workout and save key snipes using Snipes. And then you can review your highlights daily using Readwise, which will gamify the habit to stay consistent and allow you to practice spaced repetition. So we are back on my Readwise, and so I will just show you how it looks. So here, every day Readwise is creating a daily review with all of my highlights. So I have highlights from articles, books, and stuff which are curated for me every day, which is pretty cool. And here, as you can see, you can connect and sync with the different apps I just talked about. So when you go to import highlights, you will see that you can connect it to Kindle. You can even connect it to Twitter and save tweets. You can also save connect with Snipe, of course, and Reader. So that way, you have everything from this app that is coming to Readwise and will serve as your highlights. And of course, the Kortex library is synced with Readwise. So that's all the content of your library. So that was it for Readwise. Now we're going to see on Reader. So Reader, basically, as I said, the Read It Later app, amazing tool. I really, really recommend it. And you can use the Chrome extension to save any page on the internet to your library, and it will come into your inbox. And then you can decide if you're about to consume it or not. You can see the time, the author, and stuff. And the very cool thing is that, for example, if I try to read a video, I can watch the video, and at the same time, I will have the transcript just below the video, so I can watch the video and highlight the key insights that the person is saying while listening to the video, which is absolutely amazing. As I said, you can also create feeds. So feeds are basically content that will automatically be added to your reader. And it's very simple. You can subscribe to newsletter with a custom email address to subscribe to every newsletter. So that way, every newsletter you subscribe to will go automatically in your feed. And you can also add RSS feeds to your reader, and it will allow you to have them automatically added to your feed, which is always cool. And of course, you can highlight, and it's the only way to create a meaningful and intentional learning process to manage all of the content that is created every day on the internet. Then here we have Sniped. Of course, it's on the App Store, so I will let you download it. Personally, I only use the free plan. It is enough for me, but if you listen to a lot of podcasts, the paid plan may be worth it. And then we have Kindle, where I have all of my books and of course all of the highlights from the books that are there and that are synced to Readwise. So now we're going to see the Zettelkasten method. how you can turn your highlights into knowledge. And first, we're going to see why standard note taking fails. First, it's because notes remain isolated. Second, it's because notes are rarely reviewed. Third, it's because notes are not really usable for future content. And fourth, it's because notes lack consistency and connection. Of course, the Zettelkasten method is about to fix all of these problems. The Zettelkasten process is as follows. First, we have fleeting notes. Fleeting notes are the ideas that you captured, quotes, or highlights you've taken from the content you consumed using the system I just showed you for content acquisition. Then we have literature notes. Literature notes are where you are going to summarize and synthesize the key insights from your highlights. Basically, you're going to rework and rewrite your highlights with your own words, so that way you can appropriate the concept that you've studied. And then we have permanent notes, which are a breakdown of the concepts we have just synthesized with the literature note into atomic and interconnected notes. And then we're going to use links and tags to build a network of related ideas by connecting all of the permanent notes together. So if you want to apply the Zettelkasten method inside Kortex, first you need to have a library of all of your highlights from Reader, Snipes, and Kindle by syncing Readwise with your Kortex library. Then when you will be consuming a content, you will summarize major ideas from your highlights using the pre-made templates I've made. And then from these literature notes, you will be creating permanent notes respecting the atomicity principle, one note equal one concept. And then you will connect the notes using tags, links, and trigger questions to discover new insights. And you can use my tag taxonomy template for that. So to make it clearer for you, I'm going to quickly show you how it looks like in Kortex. First, we have the library. So as I said, the library is synced with Readwise and will contain all of the highlights I've taken from all of the content I've consumed, from articles, books, PDFs, newsletter, and so on. And then I have a special note called Mind Galaxy, which contains all of my literature and permanent notes. So here is an example of a literature note I have. It's on the book Flow. I started working on it. I need to enrich it a lot. But as you can see, I have different metadatas to class it by type, status, and subject. Here I have some highlights that I've copy-pasted in this element. And here in the summary part, I need to take those highlights and rewrite it and synthesize it with my own word to create my own concept that I will then extract as permanent notes. And then, for example, I will show you what a permanent note looks like. So for example, I will take this note on meta-learning, and basically you can see I have the metadata section as I just showed you. I have my big idea here, which is the concept that has been synthesized. And here at the bottom, I have different links with other documents that make sense. So that way, when I go there, I can see the connections with other notes, and that way it can spark creativity and see the interconnection between the notes. For now, we don't have a grab view inside Kortex, but I will show you in my Obsidian how it looks like when you have a related network of interconnected notes. So we are in Obsidian in the grab view, and as you can see here, I have all of my notes interconnected with each other, and so I can just navigate in this galaxy and see the links between the notes and stuff, which of course is amazing to spark creativity, creates new perspective, and create content. So as I said, we don't have the grab view yet inside Kortex, but as soon as we'll have it, you will have the ability to do the exact same thing that I'm showing you right now inside Kortex, and even more powerful features with AI synthesis and stuff that would be amazing to streamline and simplify the writing workflow. So now we're going to see the last piece of the system, which is the content creation, how you can turn your knowledge from the permanent note into impactful content. By now you have a library of valuable insights, literature notes summarizing key concepts, permanent notes interconnected in your system, and a bank of saved ideas ready to develop. If you don't have ideas, what I really recommend is to use the capture feature of Kortex. So this way, every time you need to write, you can open capture and see all of the previous ideas you've saved before and filter them by tags to find them easily. So the writing workflow I use. First, I open capture and I choose an ID. Then I write a long form. So I will try to write one long form piece each week. For example, it will be my newsletter. And I will use the long form template to guide my whole writing process that I will show you just after. And then I will repurpose the newsletter I've written into multiple short form contents, for example, tweets or reels, and I will use templates to create them and rely on my copywriter structured template for guidance. As I said in the beginning of the video, all of the templates I've mentioned so far are available. I will talk more about that in the video, so stay tuned. So now I will show you basically how it looks in Kortex. So here is an example of a newsletter I've written called the AI Trap. And here you can see a very good example of the long form template I use to structure and streamline my writing. So here, as you can see, I have the metadata As always, to link and connect documents, very important. And then I have this whole process of finding a topic, doing a brain dump, can link it with notes. So here, you know, I have this note connected. And as you can see, it was a very, very huge brain dump. I had a lot to say. It may be one of my longest newsletters. I have a resource section, which where I added highlights from my library, from content and articles I consumed. And then here in the ideation part, I've taken all of the things I've written in my brain dump and research and started to organize them in specific ways. For example, here it's about the problems. Then here it's about the goals and stuff like that. And then from then on, I already like knew what I wanted to write. So I just wrote the first draft and then second draft, and then I had the newsletter done. And then, for example, here is a tweet I have written. So as always, I have the metadata element to have the tags. I have the post just written here. And if I can add, and if I need to add links to other notes, other content from it, I can just do it there. I've mentioned my copywriting structure template, so I will show you right now. And so, for example, for short form content, what I will do is that I will open my copywriting structure in a pane. I will have my short form template just there. I will, of course, fill it with the type, subject, and platform. For example, what I will do if I want to follow some proven structure, I will copy an element and I will just paste it here. And then I will start writing following the copywriting structure that is there to structure and guide my writing. So that's a very easy way to streamline your workflow, apply proven copywriting structure, and make everything very easy, especially when you consider that you have your notes in the same place. So as soon as you need to find some reference, some things, you can always open the library to find your all highlights. You can always open your permanent notes to see which kind of things you can write on. And this way you have basically infinite ways to write, and like you never have writer's block again, because everything is very structured, streamlined, and you basically just need the energy and the motivation to start typing. So I know it was a lot of info. So if you're wondering how to apply all of this in Kortex, I've created Noah's Ark Bank, a document that links all of my templates, tools, and SOP for Kortex and applying the entire system I just showed you. Inside, you will find 3 SOPs to guide you through implementing each step of the process. So the content acquisition system SOP, the Zettelkasten method inside Kortex SOP, and the ultimate writing content system SOP. Then you will have tools to implement the system, like my tag taxonomy template to manage all of my tags and my copywriting structure template that I just showed you for writing long and short form content. You will have access to all of my note-taking templates, from my permanent note template and literature note for podcast, books, course, article, video, and so on, and my writing templates, which are the long form template and the short form template. So now, let's conclude this video. So this concludes this video on the best way to use Kortex. Kortex is an incredibly powerful tool, but without a proven system to take it to its fullest potential, you won't have many results. By following the 3 systems I just show you, you will transform the way you learn, you think, and you write. I hope it gave you valuable insight and transformed the way you're seeing your usage of Kortex. You can join Kortex by clicking on the link in the description. And if you have any question about the system I just show you, feel free to shoot me a message in the Kortex community on Discord that you can join. Don't forget to grab your 3 SOPs, template, and tool in the description. It's completely free and it will allow you to apply the whole system I just show you very easily. And if you are still feeling unsure or confused about how to use Kortex and how to apply the system I just show you, over the next 3 weeks, I'm about to release new videos showing exactly step by step how to apply each step of the process I just show you in details. I will show you in direct how I use it, so you can have a complete use case of how it works and have a very clear understanding of how you can do it yourself. So stay tuned for the future videos. I hope they will help you. I know they will. And I wish you all an amazing day. My name is Noah and welcome to the Ark.